about that sort of thing is that you get to be on the stage with a bunch of guys with their shirts off.
You know, that was the sort of the whole idea of that video was, let's take men and objectify them. Why not, you know?
But 9 records. Did you make a fortune with those records? Because you sold a lot of them.
You know, that's kind of a hard question. Yeah. No, I mean, I'm not, I don't live in a mansion. My life is not like Madonna's, no. But in terms of Canadian artist success, I would say, I guess, yes, you'd have to say I was successful. I mean, I had a life in my 20s that you know, people would envy. I got to travel around the world.
True.
I got to write rock and roll albums and be a rock star, and it was all very great and very wonderful. But I think at a certain point in your life, the novelty of that kind of wears off, and you kind of start, you know, I know I went through a period of serious reevaluation a couple of years ago, and I went, you know, why did I really start doing this in the first place? And it was the love of the art form. Of the singing and the performing and the music.
This is when you were a kid, before you started to...
No, this is a couple of years ago.
No, but you started to sing when you were a kid.
Very young, yeah, yeah. As a teenager.
And, but not that kind of stuff.
No, but I felt that the original sort of why I started doing it kind of got a bit convoluted, mm-hmm. and lost along the way. And it, you know, at a certain point, certainly in my career, I think it was almost as much about image as it was about the music. And I wanted to sort of get back to my roots. I started in theater years ago, and
where are you born? Where are you from?
I was born in Belleville, Ontario. It's a little town about an hour and a half.
I know Belleville.
Belleville, and then my father got transferred to Winnipeg, and I lived in Winnipeg till I was about 10, and then I lived in the Toronto area for almost 20 years.
Right.
Came to Vancouver 2.5 years ago. I don't know if I could go back now either. I love
the
West Coast.
Why did you come here?
change. Mm. Changed. You know, I was feeling very. I just felt as though, you know, I had a very, very strong fan base in my local area of Toronto and the Ontario region and Southern Ontario, but I felt that most of the industry and a lot of my fans really viewed me through this very myopic little lens, you know. Mm. I will forever be this sort of hard rock diva and never be allowed to sort of evolve into anything different. So it was mostly change that motivated my move out here, wanting to change my sort of surroundings. And
did you think at first, well, after you made the decision to make this change and move out here and everything, were there ever any moments where, don't you know who I am? I mean, don't you know, I used to be this. You have to start, if you start all over again, I mean, not that you were completely unknown out here, but you could walk around on the streets and everybody's going to go, ugh. Because in Toronto, man, you were the hot.
To be honest with you, I loved that when I first came out here.
Oh, you did?
Well, there was
then
a point.
Then you think, wait.
No,
never,
no, right? Actually, I mean, that's, you know, that there, I didn't get into this in the beginning to be a rock star, mm-hmm. and to be recognized and to be famous. And those are all of the side effects that come along with being a successful artist. I don't think I don't know, maybe some people do, but I didn't
lots of people do.
I didn't go into it for those reasons, you know, but I have to say that at a certain point in my career, it's pretty, you feel fairly vulnerable. And when you're walking around in a grocery store, and the stock boys are peeking around the corner and watching every move you make.
Well, especially
if you're
wearing that get-up.
Well, hey. No. Or, you know, I would go out with my hair tied back and in my track pants, and people would be looking around the corner, and I'd be going, oh, my God, they're going to see me. They're going to go, oh, my God, I saw Erin at the grocery store buying toilet paper, and she looked really scummy, you know? So,
are you working here at anything other than singing?
No.
No, you don't have to have a job or anything.
No.
A day job.
Well, you know, being an artist is a full-time job. It is a full-time job.
And I'm glad that the other half of your career, the first bit of your career, shall we say, has allowed you to pursue what you want to do. Will you sing another song?
I would love to sing another song. This is a song by one of my very favorite artists, actually someone that influenced me quite a bit, a lady named Nina Simone.
All right.
And it's a song called Sugar My Bowl.
Please. I love that song. That's
I love
so
that song.
Okay,
too.
Take your water. This is Lee Aaron, Cameron Chu at the piano.
Down in my soul, so funny, I feel so sad. I want a little steam on my clothes. Oh, maybe I can fix things up so they'll go. What's the matter, Daddy? Come on, save my soul. 'Cause I want some sugar in my bowl. I ain't fooling. I want some sugar in my bowl. Cause I want some sugar in my bowl.